St. Paul says it better than any of us in Galatians 4, verses 3 through 7, when he says, you know, when we were kids, we were all slaves to something. But God, through this woman, Mary, delivered a son. And this son gave you the right to be my son, my daughter. And not only did he give you that right, but he gave you his spirit, the spirit of sonship, the spirit of daughterhood, that enables you in fearful and weak moments to say, Abba, Father, 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 you're the one that I need. You're the one that I want. Not the fake fathers or the fake mothers, the false lovers. They are sensational and seductive, and they enslave me. They don't compose me. They don't empower me. They rob me in the end of dignity. But you restore me. You bring me back together. You clothe me. You crown me. You make me your own. So I don't have to be a slave anymore, says St. Paul to us. I can be a son. I can be a daughter. I can lay me down in peace because of whose I am. That's what both the Father and the Son did for us at Calvary. They fought for us and they won us. And that's why in Living Waters, the cross figures in so centrally. It's the emblem of unconquerable, immovable power. It is finished. It is done. The battle on my behalf, in light of all of my enslavements, has been finished. He's brought you this far. So don't be afraid. Stand firm. You will see the deliverance the Lord is going to give you. He is fighting for you. You need only to be still. Be expectant that there is more ahead. We have yet to probe all that He has in store for us. We can be assured that we have only begun to taste the height and the breadth and the depth and the width of His divine mercy towards us.